At present, people who emit greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide into the Earth's atmosphere don't pay for the damage they do or cover the cost of repairing it. A carbon price is meant to make emitting greenhouse gases into the atmosphere more expensive and to make reducing emissions by doing things like saving energy, investing in renewable energy, planting trees, more financially attractive. There are already a number of countries that have successful carbon trading schemes in place. Only a small number of large, high-emission businesses will have to participate in carbon trading, which will mean buying and trading permits. But this is a very small percentage of the businesses in our economy, maybe 1%. So how does carbon trading actually work? Well, first of all, the government sets a cap on greenhouse gas emissions each year. And over time, it tightens that cap so that less pollution is allowed to occur. Each of the participants in the trading scheme has to buy enough carbon permits to match the amount of greenhouse emissions that they produce. And every year they have to hand over those permits to the government regulator. The key to carbon trading is the balance between supply and demand of the carbon permits. If greenhouse gas emissions look like they're increasing beyond the cap the government set, then the price of permits will increase and it'll be more expensive to pollute. So the companies that find it cheapest to cut their emissions will have a stronger financial incentive to do that. And that will mean they either have to buy fewer permits, or if they've already bought the permits, they'll be able to sell them to other companies at a profit because the carbon prices are now higher. In this way, the carbon trading scheme encourages the cheapest emission reduction for our economy because the companies that can cut their emissions most cheaply are the ones that do it. And the ones that find it expensive to cut their emissions are able to simply buy permits that the other companies don't need.